Good morning, brothers and sisters, and welcome to the daily devotional of the Leeward Islands District of the Methodist Church in the Caribbean and the Americas. My name is Shari Greaves, a member of the Hope Chapel Methodist Church in the St. Kitts Circuit. Our theme for this week is the Whole Armour of God. Today, we will be focusing on the sandals, representing peace. Let us pray. Gracious God, thank you that we can use this medium to spend a few minutes in fellowship. Thank you for allowing us to see another day, as we are aware that many did not make it through the night. Thank you for health, strength, the ability to work, the friends, family, and loved ones around us who bring us joy and peace. I pray that this morning you will touch our hearts and minds, that we may be at peace today and every day, and bring peace to those around us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our text today comes from Paul's letter to the church in Ephesus, Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 13 and 15. The New Revised Standard Version reads, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to stand on that evil day, and having done everything, to stand firm. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Ephesus was a major city in ancient Rome. At the time of writing this letter, Paul was under house arrest and surrounded by Roman soldiers. It is believed that the inspiration for this section of the letter came as Paul watched the armor of the soldiers who guarded him. When we think of armor, we never really give much thought to shoes. But let us pause for a minute to examine shoes. Imagine having to walk for 20 minutes in shoes that are too small, too narrow, too tall, or have no support. After the first few steps, we will start to feel uncomfortable. And by the end of the journey, we will have blisters, bruises, and swollen ankles. Some may even remove the shoes in the middle of the journey. And let us consider the sandals of the Roman soldiers. Straps over the toes and the foot and around the ankle for support, with comfortable soles and studs underneath for grip. There are two aspects to the shoes we wear. The first is the soles that keep us going over challenging grounds. Our feet take us where we want to go. We traverse over hot sand, hot asphalt roads, water-lined paths. We deal with persons who try to put us down at every opportunity so that they can make themselves look good at our expense. Shoes protect us from the people and dangers that want to prevent us from completing our task. We are challenged to step forward in faith, remembering that we do not rely on our own strength and courage, but on God. The second is to equip us with something to offer persons along our journey. Christ brought us out of the kingdom of darkness and into the kingdom of light by preaching his message of peace and allowing us to have peace with others. Jesus brings us peace with God and peace in difficult times, and encourages us to be at peace with our families, neighbors, and friends. After all, when we have the peace of God with us, who will be against us? As believers, we have our own struggles. Personally, I struggle with health issues and have regular discussions with my doctor regarding the medications I take. I take medications to improve my health, but adverse side effects mean I have to take other medications to counteract the side effects of the first set of medications. It is very easy to become overwhelmed and give up. However, Paul encourages us to take up the whole armor of God to be able to withstand evil on the days that our faith is tested. We are also encouraged to stand firm so that we can be ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. We have many struggles, and we'll never be able to escape them by our own power. However, as we remember that God is more powerful than any medical issue, any bad-tempered co-worker, any feuding family members, any person that hates us without knowing us, any thought that says we are not good enough, any temptation that comes our way, we put on our shoes and go forth in faith. We go forth to teach others about our faith so that they may know the same peace that is in Christ Jesus. I close with the words found at the end of Peter's second letter. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of our Lord as salvation. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.